Street art has become hot property, with exhibitions opening every week and sometimes millions of pounds at stake. As for the artists, they're an elusive bunch, but Blast have been hard at work to bring you the hottest talent from the scene. This artist started out on the street and now exhibits his work in galleries worldwide. We caught up with D-Face at his latest show in London.
My name is D-Face and my art form is pop art. I like to keep anonymous because I think my work should speak for itself. It's not important that you know what I look like. No. My current show, Apocalypse Now, is a reference to pop art and my inspirations from that, such as Warhol, Lichtenstein. It's about subverting popular imagery. It's about questioning advertising. We're constantly bombarded with icons, logos, messages, advertising slogans all the time. These images are iconic. I subvert them and distort them and get them to have a different meaning. The Superman ha 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 piece, it's referencing obviously comic book culture, which I grew up with. What I wanted to get across is what happens to those superheroes now when they're no longer relevant to today's society. Every image has a story, every image has a backstory to them. I started off with one character that I would just draw on vinyl and put it up in the streets. And developed more characters, but it always came back to the dog, as it's become known, and the wings icons. Whilst I don't call myself a graffiti artist, the spray can itself is a really iconic figure. What I wanted to do is do my own monument to that. I don't think it's that important to create a stir about your work. If you're doing the right thing, then that will follow you. Don't talk about it, go and do it.
And next, Mr. Jago from Bristol, a city notorious for street art.
I'm not anonymous because I started my career commercially. I didn't start as an urban rebel. I went and painted a wall, got caught about 15 minutes later. So I went straight into my doodle books, my sketchbooks, and eventually evolved my own characters. I was heavily influenced by the graffiti. Everything from that kind of movement has inspired me, as well as things like comics, record sleeves. I've got books and books just filled with doodles, and it's just freestyle fiddling with a pen. I think a lot of artists that I know have started off in the doodle school. It's just that you wouldn't take it seriously. You wouldn't think, oh, this is an art form. Doodling comes into my work the way that I kind of let go a little bit. You're just literally messing around on some paper. I've evolved a particular line, then that's evolved into making marks. Making a mark is making a mark with anything. It could be with a brush, with a pencil. But my technique on silk, for example, dribbling the gutter, that's like drawing, but with a bit of chaos involved. It's quite random. I make a lot of happy accidents. I studied illustration at university. Started doing commissions for various companies. That's how come I started getting out there. One of the most exciting cases of having my doodles used commercially was having them used in a video for the Red Hot Chili Peppers. You've got Flea jumping around with his bass, but at the same time, there's butterflies that I've drawn in my little boring bedroom and scanned in and sent to him. It takes it to a whole new dimension, and obviously to the rest of the world.
Graffiti has been inspiration for many current artists, and he is a man who has managed to make it his living, David Samuel.
I'm a commissioned graffiti artist. I'm a shop proprietor and a graffiti artist. I've made a trade out of it. I'm obsessed with graffiti. Any type of street art and typography and letters and structure of letters, obsessed completely. Where I grew up, it was surrounded by three other estates. I thought, you know what, forget all that crime. I don't want to rob anyone, I don't want to take anything from a shop, I want to paint. Graffiti took me away from a whole world that is easy to get involved in on an estate in London. I'd learnt a certain style of painting with graffiti. It's called cutback, and everyone was just like, what are you doing? Look at that, that's amazing, you can make money from this, move into that. Which kind of led on to me actually doing canvases. Nowadays, I've got the shop and I'm legal, I paint legally. I've painted for the police force with anti-knife crime. I paint for the council. It's like community work, you know? Just smartening the place up. I love painting walls, big walls, massive walls where you need ladders. Just finished a big job in Brighton at a nightclub. Done a bit of a dig at Damien Hirst, who've taken his polka dot. Switched it up so it's not exactly his, he can't say anything about it. I've produced it across the whole front of this club. You make this painting with your finger out of a spray can. You get to do your thing, it's an amazing feeling. I'm an artist now, and it's what it's led to. And I'm still finding my feet in that whole art world. It's hard work, it's not easy. Running a business and paying the rent and paying the bills and paying the taxes. But it's a really nice feeling. I don't want to become president or anything, I just want to, you know, do my thing.